Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest model truck review video to come onto this channel. This one is another Oxford Diecast model, and this one is a DAF XF, although it does have a different front to the older version that I have previously covered. And this one is a container wagon version, as this one is branded into the Maritime livery. Just to turn the box around, as I like to do this quickly before we get into the review. This one is 76DXF001. Therefore, you can tell it is a different type compared to the other one. I'm not entirely sure when this model was released, as I did buy this in a job lot of model trucks for a project last year, although that project is not going ahead, so these are just going to be reviewed before I sell them on and replace them with another project that I am working on, of which is European model trains, as these we'll go towards that once they are disposed of. But anyways, enough of that for this video, as this is just a review to tell my version of what these models are actually like, as I do try to be honest and truthful with these models, as I'm not supported or sponsored by anybody, and everything I buy is paid for out of my own pocket. So therefore, I use that as a perfect excuse to give honest feedback and views on this model. Hence, that my reviews are unofficial. Always have been and always will be. Anyways, next thing to do, I'm going to remove the packaging off camera and I shall return with some close-ups. Okay then, now that the packaging is all removed, next thing to do is to follow up with the close-ups. And this will be before we cover the rotation in the next segment of this video. As you may know by now, I now split these reviews into three parts, of which is the introduction, close-ups, and then the rotation, as I do try to improve on my content. And I'm using this month of July 2020, in this case, to enhance my videos. So all feedback is definitely welcome, both positive and constructive. I will definitely listen to you. But anyways, just taking the camera, I'm gonna turn the truck just slightly towards the camera so we get the front view. And just to zoom in on the top, as you may be familiar with these trucks in Euro Truck Simulator 2, the marker lights on the top are glazed, so that's definitely some good points for Oxford Diecast on this model as well. It does have fully separate fitted wing mirrors and glazed headlights as well. This one is registered as EU15TTY, and the headlights are also glazed, so that's grand, although most of the detail elsewhere is printed. But factoring in the price of these models new, they are very good for detail despite the low costs, as these cost around £20 to £25 UK brand new, although I picked this one up pre-owned, which came in a job lot of model trucks. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to turn the turntable back and then just to unlock the tripod again so the camera doesn't rock about, Let's zoom in on the truck carb. As you can probably tell from this angle, there is a basic cab interior, as with all of the Oxford Diecast model trucks. Sadly, there is no rotation on this, correction, there is no flush glazing on this model, as with the other two trucks from Oxford that I have covered, although some of their model buses do have flush glazing. So I will have to knock a point off, as much as I don't want to, but I'm going to be honest in my reviews and I'm not going to be biased, as that doesn't really help anybody. Fleet number, oops, just bear me whilst this camera regains focus. Fleet number is 2535. There is no light bar on the top like you get with some other specifications of these trucks. But although most of the detail is printed, it is very crisp and clear, and I think it is excellent for how much these trucks actually cost, as they are very good models in my opinion, and they are perfect for any UK or Irish 00 gauge model railway. And just to point out another thing as well, the container, of which we'll just come to, this does detach once the packaging straps are removed. However, I have kept these on, and it's a good thing I didn't remove them in the end, because I would have had to have double-sided taped the container onto the trailer. If that were the case, if I was to sell it later, but sadly, none of these model trucks will be staying in my fleet, that are the 00 gauge ones anyways, as I'm looking more for HO scale models, of which more of those will be covered on this channel in the future. And that is it for the close-ups of this section of the video. So the next thing to do is to move on to the next segment of this review, and which will be the final portion before drawing this video to a close, and that will be a 360 degree rotation. It's now time for the 360 degree rotation, and this time around I have zoomed out already before filming, as hopefully the truck and the camera are in the right position and I shouldn't need to pan the camera at all, but I will make fine adjustments where needed. And let's crack on with the rotation then. As per the close-ups, the detail is very grand on this model, and it's basically very much self-explanatory. I do like the quality of these models. Sadly, the container is not attached to the trailer at all, hence the reasons why it is slightly offset, but this can be corrected. But I'm just keeping it like this for now, as it avoids having to remove the straps just to retape it back on. And but you can use any container with this truck, which is grand. So if you want to add your own trailers and stuff, I believe you can unscrew the cab from the chassis if you wanted to fit your own driver into the leading cab of this truck, of which I have done in the past, which was with the BP tanker. There was a Scania, and I did that back in 2014 when I was living in England. However, that's another topic, and I may do something like that with the HO scale vehicles in the future. But anyways, sticking on topic, it's time to wrap up this review. And to be honest and fair to the model and factored in the detail and the features, I think a 9 out of 10 is a fair and justified score. And that concludes this review. As always, have a good week or weekend. Take care, all the best, and God bless. See you later, and cheerio.